Yo, dude, what's up?
Shri Ganeshaya Namaha.
Jai Ganesh, Jai Ganesh. Jai Ganesh Deva, Madharani Parvati.
Shri Ganeshaya Namaha.
Shri Ganeshaya Namaha.
Hey, you're gonna run us over or what?
Hey, watch out!
He's gone mad!
Hey, how's it going, guys? Look, here comes our superhero. Hi, guys! Hey, dude. You invite us to your place and then you yourself make a grand late entrance? We are fed up of you showing off all the time. This is too much.
Hey, chill man, relax.
You know how Bal Ganesh taught Kuber a lesson for his showing off habits? After witnessing that, I don't think I want to show off anymore. That is just the reason why I've invited you guys over. Otherwise, I would never hang out with losers like you. Just look at yourselves, man.
I see. By the way, do you know? A donkey dressed in fine clothes is still a donkey.
The pot calling the kettle black.
Come on, guys. Let's get out of here. We didn't come here to be insulted and treated like dirt by him.
Hey, guys. Take a chill pill. Don't take it to your heart, man. I was just joking, my friends. Come on. Your sense of humor is pretty pathetic, dude. Please don't crack jokes like this out in public. Or people will think all mice are dumb as you. Okay? So dude, just give it a rest and zip it. Huh? Come on, now tell us. Why are you so late?
I thought it would be nice if we could hang out and go for a nice long drive in my car. But you are such party poopers. You guys just don't want to get out of your homes. Huh? Who knows which side of the bed you wake up from, man? Huh? You have turned my beautiful garden into a hellhole. What is this?
Anyways, whatever. Get on with it. Why have you called us here?
Listen up. Our dear Lord Ganeshji and our famous ancestor Mushak Raj did a great job in the film Bal Ganesh. Super film, right? I mean, never mind the kids. Even the kids' parents and grandparents were glued to the screen watching different stories. Right now, they just can't get enough of them, man. And so they are demanding more and more stories. Or they threaten to ban all mice from their kitchens forever. Hey! So guys, should we give in to their demands and tell them more stories?
Yes, yes, we should.
You don't want to be banned.
This will make the parents happy and the kids happy too. And once kids are happy, then not just us, the whole world will be happy. What do you say?
Yeah, sure. Why not? We'll all have a blast. You remember, don't you? All those adventure stories of Bal Ganesh?
And now, it's time to begin our story of Shiv Shambhu and his queen Parvati in all her glory. One day, at their home. The instructions of Mother Gauri, Nandi disobeyed that morn. So, through divine intervention, to Parvati, Shri Ganesh was born. Mother Parvati gave the instruction to stand on guard and cause obstruction. Watch out! Beware! Beware! Watch out! Then along came Shiva, who's denied entry by brave Ganesh, our fierce little sentry. Nandi tried to intervene, but he was flung out. Oh, what a scene! Brahmaji's efforts came to naught, so Lord Shiva was consumed with wrath. With his weapon, he dealt a blow, and Ganesh's head fell into the snow. Parvati wept and was filled with resentment for Shivji, who was truly repentant. The head of an elephant soon was found and attached to the body that lay on the ground. The gods then issued a proclamation that Ganesh would be raised in veneration, not Brahman or Vishnu nor Mahesh, but the Lord of Lords would be Ganesh! Jai Ho! Jai Ho! Jai Ho! So Parvati and Lord Mahesh spent happy days with little Ganesh. This pot-bellied kid was always greedy for sweets and Modak's always needy. Then along came Parshuram, a holy sage, but Ganesh snubbed him, which threw him in a rage. He sought the aid of his divine weapon and attacked Lord Ganesh to teach him a lesson. Ganesh lost a tooth with one blow, so why he's called Ek Dant now we know. Suddenly, across the heavens, a shadow fell. Surpdaman was causing havoc and hell. None of the gods were a match for him, so Lord Indra fled. Things looked grim. Indraji, now safe and sound, towards the south he was bound. Surpdaman, thirsty for revenge, caused drought in the land, this escape to avenge. Sage Agastya performed a sacrifice. Lord Brahma appeared and gave him advice. The Ganga waters from Shiva's hair he collected and carried with great care. Little Ganesh, disguised as a crow, tipped the pot and the water overflowed. Into the land the water swarmed, and that's how the river Kaveri was formed. Ganpati Bappa Moria, Mangalamurti Moria, Ganpati Bappa Moria, Mangalamurti Moria. Little Ganesh loved his brother with every beat of his heart. But sometimes between the two of them, a little fight would start. Then a solution came from Narad the wise. To encircle the globe, he instructed the boys. Whoever completed the task assigned and flew around the world the fastest, in every realm would be declared the bravest and the smartest. Astride a peacock, Karthik flew to cross the seas and skies of blue. While little Ganesh, our clever friend, to encircle his parents he began. When it was done, he said to the sage, I've completed your task according to plan. The sage was confused. Lord Shiva amused. Faces glowed. Hearts overflowed. Why fly all over aimlessly? My parents mean the world to me. Jai Ho! Now here's a story of one night when the moon was shining full and bright. On Mushak's back he rode along.
That little mouse was rather strong.
Hopping along slowly, steadily, our two friends made their way home happily, when suddenly a snake came in sight and Mushak stopped in his tracks in fright. Into the snow poor Ganesh fell with the Modak scattered pell-mell. Chandrama laughed at this funny sight, but Ganesh grew angry and uptight. He cursed Chandrama with all his might, who soon began to lose his light. His face grew dark and dull and dim. He fell before Ganesh and begged of him. Seeing that he was filled with remorse, Ganesh was no longer cross. Moved to pity with his plight, he gave Chandrama back his light. Now listen well to this famous story, where greed for wealth brings no glory. On his royal chariot, Kuber rode and soon arrived at Shivji's abode. An invitation he extended to show off his wealth he intended. Shivji realized the plan in his head and suggested Ganesh go instead. Kanchan Palace was indeed marvelous, the food tasty and delicious. Ganesh's belly began to stuff, but the food did not seem quite enough. The more they filled upon his plate, the more he ate and ate and ate. Even when his plate was clean, to eat some more, he was keen. Kuber knew he was in trouble, his pride was soon reduced to rubble.
Back to Shivji, he then stumbled his arrogance he knew was humbled. Forgive my foolishness, O Lord, no more will I show off, he implored. Shivji, this could understand, placed a bowl of rice in his hand and told him to give it to Ganesh to eat and never the same mistake repeat. Shivji's trick left a deep impression and Kuber went home having learned his lesson.
Yeho!
Ganpati Bappa Moria, Mangal Murti Moria. 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 Ganpati Bappa Moria, Mangal Murti Moria.
So listen, dudes. One thing you better keep in mind, okay? Anything that is overdone, the kids of today are not going to accept. So that is why we have put together at least 3 to 4 stories to tell them in a style they like. Hey, enough thinking and pondering. It's time for some action, dude. Action!
Not just action.
Let's rock!
Run! The cat is coming! Run! Run! Come on, hurry up! Hurry up! Hurry up!
Let's run!
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 Stay alive! Run! Run!
Let's hide! Let's hide! But where should I hide?
Hide behind the car, you dodo! Hurry up!
We are saved!
Hey, you guys are really useless! Frightened of a cat, huh? I mean, look at me! When I am around, don't even mention tension.
It's because of you we have enough tension. You can put us all in a soup and slink off in your car.
Hang on, I couldn't think of a single story that our audience would have liked to listen to. But I have a feeling that cat was sent by Bal Ganesh to remind me of the interesting story about the cat and his own life.
This feels so good. God bless you, Nandi Maharaj. Just keep rocking me like this forever. I'm absolutely loving it. Now, if only my Mooshak was around.
But I'm right here.
Just like he takes me for rides on his back, I'd love to give him a ride on my swing. This is amazing.
My lord, I'm right here down below. And I know very well you're doing this on purpose to tease me.
Bal Ganesh?
Yes, Nandi?
I thought I just heard Mushak's voice coming from somewhere. But I don't see him anywhere. Mooshak! Where are you, my friend? Come out from wherever you are. Little Ganesh is longing to be with you.
Am I a bird? Why is everyone looking up at the sky for me?
I say, little mouse, have you seen our friend Mooshak Raj anywhere around? In fact, he looks a lot like you.
Hey, this is Mooshak himself. Nandi, let him climb up on the swing.
Yes, of course.
Mooshak, come on up here. Come on, quick.
Very well. So you finally notice your old friend, Ganeshji.
Come on, climb up here. Hey, Nandi, slow down a bit. Mooshak, come up here fast.
I'm trying.
See how much fun I'm having here.
Fatso? Yeah, right. Go ahead, make fun of me. I'll get back at you, bait and watch. My lord?
Yes, Mooshak?
In spite of having so many friends around you, I'm the one you decided to poke fun at. I'm going. When you're in the mood to go for a ride, you may call me. Because I'm very well aware that you prefer a ride on my back much more than a ride on that stupid swing.
Oh no, I think he's upset.
Nobody really cares for me. Everyone's always making fun of me.
Hey Mushak, hang on! There is no need to get upset. Sometimes it is good to have fun at each other's expense. It keeps things light and happy. Besides a ride on your back and my mom's yummy modaks, there is nothing else in the whole world that I prefer.
Flatter me all you like. I'm out of here. help, my lord. Help, my lord. Help me, please.
Now what's the matter? Mushak, what happened?
My lord, back there.
Hey,
back there.
Why are you shivering and shaking?
My lord, there's a...
What's going on, Mushak? What happened? A moment ago, you thought you didn't need me. And now you're clinging to me like a leech, stuttering and screaming.
My lord, I think I'm having a very bad day today. First you all made fun of me, and that big cat over there had a run at me. My lord, there's a huge cat who chased me.
You got scared of a cat? Very well, I will go and check out myself who this cat is that dared to scare my best friend. Let's go, Mushak.
No, not me. I won't come. You go yourself, my lord.
Mushak got scared of a cat.
Mushak, cat!
Help me, my lungs!
Stop it, Mushak. Get a grip. Bal Ganesh, you better take care of your friend Mushak and the cat that seems to torment him. It's time for Bholenath Shiv Shankar to come out of his meditation. I promised to take him up for a ride to Mount Kailash. I'd better hurry.
Very well, Nandi. You carry on. I am going to tackle that cat who dared to frighten my friend Mushak. Mushak, where is that cat? Everyone look out for it!
Where is that cat? Where is she? How could she have disappeared so fast?
You're supposed to look for a cat, not me. Where is it? There she is! After her! Guys, she's here! So you're the terrible cat who's been traumatizing my poor friend.
Don't let her get away.
Got you now. You know what? I'm in a very playful mood today. So how about a little game just you and me, huh? I see. You are getting all coy in front of me, huh? I am going to teach you a lesson you won't forget. No one messes with my friend, understand? I am going to give you a taste of your own medicine. Mushak!
Get up, you clumsy oaf! We've got to catch that cat!
Ugh.
Run, Vatsal, run!
Today I'm going to teach you a lesson! I won't give up. At last, what are you going to do now?
Got you. Uh-huh. Oh, so what are you mewing about now? You led us all on a wildcat chase. Wanna mess with me now?
Quiet, Mushak. I think I'm going to have a little game with our friend here.
What a horrible voice she has.
Sounds like she needs some oiling.
What was that? Pardon me? Oh, I see. I say, Mushak, this cat just told me that she's dying to take a bath.
Oh, yes, sure.
It's just a small wish. Why don't we grant it to her?
Oh, sure. That will teach her a lesson. Serves you right. Now you'll think twice before you go around scaring mice ever again in your life.
Come. Come to me, sweetie. I can help you out of the water. Come. Now that you've learnt your lesson, I'd be more than happy to help you. What's the matter? Tired already? Is that all you're capable of? The next time I catch you playing pranks like that, I'll make it worse for you. I won't let you get away with it so easily. Now beat it! And no more scaring mice!
Yes!
That's over and out. But all that running around has made me really hungry. Come on, Musha. Let's get back and sink our teeth into more yummy Modaks. Mom, where are you? Mom, I'm absolutely famished. May I please have some of your Modaks? Let's see if she's in there. Mother Parvati, I have got a great story to tell her while she feeds me some of her yummy Modaks. Mom, it's you? Mother, tell me who did this to you?
I won't let him get away. Even if he's hiding in the farthest corner of the earth, I will find him.
You did it.
I did?
You did?
Yes, you did.
Mother, what are you talking about? Huh? Me? You know, I wouldn't even dream of hurting you in any way.
My son.
Yes, Mother?
That cat that you harassed today, It was actually me, son.
You? But how can that be possible, mother? And you know what? I was not intentionally harassing the cat. She frightened Musha, so I decided to teach her a lesson.
Yes, yes.
You be quiet. Huh? I am very well aware who all were watching the fun and having a good laugh at the cat's expense.
But mother...
Ganesh, all the living creatures on this earth, the animals, birds and beasts, they are all created by the same God. As for me, in some form or the other, I too am alive in some helpless creature. So when you cause harm to any poor helpless creature, then you are causing harm to me too. Today you were mean to a poor, innocent, stray little homeless cat. As a result, you were mean to me too. Huh? Oh. You've caused a lot of pain to your dear mother, my son Ganesh. Oh.
I realize that I have done wrong, mother. This was not the way for me to go about things. Please forgive me. I should never have behaved in this manner. Even though it was unintentional, I have hurt you very badly. What you said is absolutely true. We should never have fun at the cost of someone else's feelings. I promise you from this day onward, I shall never take advantage of anyone weaker than me. In fact, I shall do my best to help them.
Yes, me too.
My son, I am relieved that you have realized your mistake. And henceforth, my loving son will be a refuge for poor homeless creatures. But how can this happen on an empty stomach?
Huh?
Come on then. Do you know what? I've prepared a whole lot of fresh modaks just for you. Don't you want some?
Hmm? Have we ever said no to modak?
There you go. All of those are just for you.
Mom, you're simply the best.
Ganesh ji was only trying to help his friend Mushak from the cat so that she wouldn't harm him. But his mother Parvati helped him understand an important thing, that one should never take advantage of those who are helpless.
But then, if you really think about it, we mice too are helpless as cats, aren't we?
Absolutely right!
Oh no. Guys, I completely forgot. Do you remember the cat that scared us earlier? We could have told her the same story as well. Hey, then she would have told it to the other cats and we could have all lived happily together.
Hey, hang on, Mr. Dance. You were the ones who were frightened and ran away from that silly cat, not me, okay?
Liar.
And secondly, the cat came in here before we even began the story, my friend. Yeah, maybe it is possible. She would have become your friend after listening to the story. But what if she walloped you all even before listening to the story, huh? What then?
No need to worry. I have an idea. Now when they release the DVDs of this film, you can distribute copies in the entire cat colony for free. Maybe then they'll have a change in attitude.
What crap? Why should I distribute DVDs for free, huh? You guys think that I'm the only mouse they want to eat? Are they allergic to your body odor or something? If they are to be distributed, we all should do it together. But by the way, your suggestion is a pretty intelligent one, I have to admit.
Speaking of intelligence, I remember another story about Ganesh, which was narrated to me by your grandfather.
What? You mean my grandfather told you the story? Then why didn't he tell it to me too, huh?
I think you better ask him that question, didn't you hear? He said it was a story about being intelligent. No wonder he didn't share it with you. He knows how intelligent you are. Dhoti, why don't you continue with your story?
You guys know just how smart and intelligent Ganeshji was, don't you?
Yes, we do.
In the previous film, Bal Ganesh was asked to fly 3 times around the world. He displayed his intelligence by simply walking around his parents 3 times. So now I'm gonna tell you another story about our intelligent friend.
Om Brahma Devaya Namaha. 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 Om Brahma Devaya Namaha.
Open your eyes, my son. Tell me, what is it you desire?
Greetings, Lord Brahma. Forgive me for putting you through this inconvenience. But I simply cannot understand what to do.
Do not hesitate, Munivar. Go right ahead and say what's on your mind.
I have just started writing a book of scriptures in the form of verses and couplets. But to be able to complete it, my lord, I need the help of someone very intelligent. Someone who will be able to write down everything simultaneously as I speak. Because in case I do stop in between, I might forget the verses. And the scriptures will never be completed, my lord.
You must go up to Mount Kailash, and there you will meet Lord Shiv Shankar. He is the only one who can help you with this task.
As you command, my lord.
Blessings be upon you.
Sage Vyas, here.
Long live Lord Bholenath. Heartiest greetings to Mother Parvati too.
May you be blessed, O noble sage.
My lord.
My divine insight has already informed me exactly why you are here, noble sage. Do not be anxious. For your problem, I have a solution. Ganesh.
Bal Ganesh?
Yes, Munivar. Our very own son, Ganesh.
Nandi, go. Go and fetch Bal Ganesh at once.
As you command, Bholenath.
I don't understand a word of it.
Mushak?
Yes?
What do you think you're doing?
My lord, this is a difficult word. But I won't give up. I shall make sure I study and understand it well. After all, you're the most intelligent god in the whole world and I'm your vehicle. And I shall reward myself with a Modak only after I've learned the word well.
In that case, I think you will have to stay hungry for a very long time, my dear smart Mushak.
Huh? Why is that? Very well, I shall read it right now.
Listen, you nincompoop. When the words are straight up, you have difficulty reading. And now it is upside down, you're trying to read it? Now try.
You know what, my lord? I think I'll eat the modak first, then I'll try reading it. What I mean is, I'll try to read. Because now that the book is straight, it has become more difficult to read it, my lord.
Never mind. I will teach you how to read, my friend. Now repeat after me. Always honor thy father and mother.
Always honor thy father and mother.
Well done. Now try reading it yourself.
Greetings, Bal Ganesh. How are you, Mushakraj?
Very well,
thank
you.
By the way, Nandi, have you also come to try reading the scriptures like our friend here?
No, Bal Ganesh. Reading big books is something I shall leave only to Mushakraj. The reason I am here is to tell you that Bholenath has asked you to come immediately.
Father wishes to see me. Let's go.
He said I've picked up reading really fast. So I guess it's time for my reward, huh? Huh? Ganesh is leaving. Wait for me, my lord. I'm coming too. Wait for me.
Greetings, father. Greetings, mother. Munivar, how come you're here?
Ganesh, my son. Munivar is about to begin writing a book of holy scriptures, for which he is in need of someone smart and intelligent who can write as fast as he recites. I have a feeling that there is no one better than you for this task, my son.
As you command, father. Shall we, Munivar?
Oh, yes. I'll take your leave, my lord.
My lord, why don't you tell him?
Munivar?
Yes?
I shall certainly help you write your book, but only on one condition.
What kind of condition could he have?
You will have to keep reciting non-stop as I write.
I see.
If you pause even to take a breath, Munivar, then I shall stop writing immediately.
Very well, son of Gauri. But I too have a condition for you. Whatever couplet I recite, you will write it down only after you understand it fully.
Only after I understand it?
Under this pretext, if I get tired, I shall give him a complicated couplet, which he will have to rack his brains to try and understand. During which time, I can pause for a nice deep breath.
I accept your condition. Well, what are you thinking about? Shall we begin?
Indeed, we shall begin, little Ganesh.
Thank you. Mushak.
Yes, my lord. Here you go.
Continues, I'm never going to finish writing.
Ganesh, Ganesh, my son, this sacrifice of yours shall not go in vain.
So the scriptures are finally done.
Here you are, Munivar. Your book is finally ready.
Ganesh ji. This book is a result of your own intelligence, diligence, and the sacrifice you have made. I cannot think of anyone else in the whole world who could have made this happen. Thank you, Ganesh ji. May you be blessed abundantly.
And that is how the renowned epic Mahabharata was written and compiled by Ganesh ji. So you see, besides being an intelligent little boy, he was a great writer as well.
Wow, what a rocking story that was. I had a blast. Yo, Master Blaster, did you finally get it? Why your grandfather didn't narrate that story to you? Oh no, don't tax your puny little brain. I'm sure you'll understand with time. Anyway, that's the end of that story. Now, since we have made a promise to entertain the kids out there, we've got to rock things a bit, man. So, shall we? We'll have a bit of a break as well. What say, dudes? Enjoy!
Do you guys remember, in the previous film Bal Ganesh, how our friend Mushak Raj and his mice friends danced and rocked the mountains for Ganesh ji? So, how about some of that rock and roll again?
Let's hit it!
प्यारा है यही दोस्त हमारा है गन्नू सबका प्यारा है यही दोस्त हमारा है जो भी
the Lord. Come on everybody with me, praise the Lord. Come on everybody with me, praise the Lord. Come on everybody with me, praise the Lord. Come on everybody with me.
Sab devon mein sabse pyara duniya mein mashhoor hai. Koi dard musibat aaye humse na ye door hai. Sab devon mein sabse pyara duniya mein mashhoor hai. Koi dard musibat aaye humse na ye door hai. झुका के बोलिया हर साल है मन भावन दरबार है जिसका घर होता खुशहाल है
इस बरस जो आया अगले बरस भी आ हमें दरस दिखाया हमें दरस दिखा
जयकारा बोलो मन खुशियों से डोलिया
लोटांगण वंदीन चरण डोळ्यान पाहिन रूप तुझे प्रेमे आलिंगिन आनंदे पूजिन भावे वाळेन म्हणे नामा त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव बंधुश्च सखा त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव सर्वं मम देवदेव कायेन वाचा मनसिन्द्रियेन वा बुद्ध्यात्मना वा प्रकृतिस्वभावात् करोमि यज्ञं सकलं परस्मै नारायणाय इति समर्पयामि अच्युतं केशवं रामनारायणं विष्णुदामोदरं वासुदेवं हरिश्रीधरं माधवं गोपिकावल्लवं जानकीनायकं रामचन्द्रं भजे हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे
Yo, Master Blaster, why don't you give us an idea? What is the next story going to be about?
Listen, you guys. You know nothing means more to me than my set of wheels here. So how about the story of Bal Ganesh's set of wheels, meaning his mousy friend and vehicle Mushak Raj, and how he and Ganesh met for the very first time.
Hey! Let's see who makes it to the top of the Himalayas first.
I'm going to make sure I defeat you this time.
Hey, you're trying to trip me over.
Trip you?
Hey, where has everyone disappeared?
Hey, Mushak! Don't think you can win by tripping me!
Okay, so once I get down there, I'll be the winner.
Mushak, wait!
Here they come.
I can beat you at your own game!
Oh, so you wanna mess with me, huh? Just you wait, I'll show you what Mushak's all about.
Huh? Ganeshji! Here I come!
Well, Mushak Raj, Looks like you want to relive the past again. Why are you cheating like those awful monsters? Do you remember the time when you created havoc all over the place and tried to challenge me too?
How could I ever forget those awful days?
Open your eyes, Gajmukhasur. I am pleased with your devotion towards me.
Prabhu.
Go on. Ask for whatever you desire.
By the grace of your presence, my entire life has been transformed. All I ask is this, that no god, nor man, no demon, nor beast shall ever be able to defeat me.
With my blessings, your wish has been granted, Gajmukhasur. But you must always make sure that you never misuse your power, or else the gods will once again have the reason to say that naive Shiv Shankar gets carried away with the devotion of demons and grants their wishes.
No, my lord. I wish to use my powers only to help people in their hour of need, Bholenath. I remain your humble servant and shall forever be at your service.
May you be blessed, Gajmukhasur.
Bholenath, you are indeed very naive. I am your greatest devotee, I am. But I just can't seem to help it. Sometimes I too make some mistakes. After all, I'm a monster.
Om Bhagwan Vishnu Mangalam Garudvaja Mangalam Pundlikaksh Mangalam Mohari Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu.
Offering prayers to God, huh? Oh, my minions, capture them all! Now on they will only worship me! Don't let anyone get away! Devraj Indra, I'm coming to get you!
What's this?
The gods shall be my slaves too! Don't let even one of them escape! Bholenath has blessed me with invincible strength. Now nobody can destroy me. Me.
Ganesh, my son, why are you so quiet today?
My lord! My lord! My lord!
Nandi? What is it?
Bholenath, Bholenath, the gods have come to see you. They seem very scared.
Scared?
Greetings, Bholenath.
We are finished, Bholenath. Gajbukasur has turned even more violent after the boon you granted him.
What?
Even as we speak, he is causing havoc all over the place, my lord. He attacks anyone without any reason at all. Go on, ask Varundev. What's this? Where is Varundev?
Please calm down. Calm down, Devraj. Gajmukhasur had made me a promise that he would never use his powers towards any devious motives.
Varundev?
What happened? Who did this? And why? Earthquake!
What was that? Did I just hear the sound of mountains quake? Don't tell me the gods have brought along an earthquake with them.
Ganesh? You shouldn't say things like that, my son.
I hope you are convinced now. All this is being caused by your devotee, Gajmukhasur.
You know, my lord, you get enticed much too easily.
Somehow I knew this would happen. Gajmukhasur has made a very big mistake by disobeying my orders. But do not worry yourselves at all. I shall definitely teach him a lesson. Ganesh, my son.
Yes, father?
You are the only one who can take him to task, my son. Go. Go and punish him for all his wrongdoings.
As you command, father, you shall have nothing to worry about. I can tackle that demon and set him right once and for all.
But my lord, how can he? And that too all alone?
Wait a minute, Bal Ganesh. I shall go with you too.
Yes, Ganesh. Please let Nandi and your friends accompany you. Thanks to the blessings of Bholenath, Gajmukhasur is practically invincible. Your companions will be of great help when confronting him.
Yes, exactly.
No, mother. I'm sure I can handle that demon by myself. Please don't be worried. I'll defeat him and be back as quickly as possible to gobble up your yummy modaks. And I am sure I am going to be starving after that big fight.
Ganesh ji, please don't be so stubborn. Please listen to what your mother is saying. Gajmukhasur is not at all easy to defeat.
Yes.
Everyone, please be silent. I have absolute confidence in Bal Ganesh's strength and intelligence. He can certainly do this on his own. Go, my son. Go and carry out my instructions.
As you command, father. I see. So this is where all the demons are hanging out. Let me tackle his cronies first. Come and get me, come and get me. Catch me if you can.
Come on.
Ready to give up? Gajmukha sir! Why are you hiding like a coward? Your days of attacking helpless people are over forever! Today I'm here to teach you a good lesson for misusing the powers granted to you by Bholenath.
Not even the mighty gods and the demons have been able to defeat me. You're nothing, just a puny little brat. Any one of my minions can finish you now.
Gajmukha sir, your minions have already paid a very heavy price for messing with me. And now, it's time for your turn.
Naive innocent fool! What you have done to my minions is not good at all. But you don't know what I'm capable of. I've been granted a boon that no god, no man, no monster can do anything to harm me. So now, I'm going to make you pay for what you have done.
Gajmukha sir, I think we've had enough of playing games. Now it's time for some tough man-to-man action. I'm far beyond the boon that you have been granted because I have the body of a human and the head of an elephant.
Take this!
there is nothing you can do to harm me.
Is that so?
My ears! My ears! My lord, please forgive me. I promise not to do any more evil deeds ever. And I shall stay in this form. And I shall be at your service all my life.
Well, all right. And besides, I really enjoyed taking a ride on your back. So from today onwards, I'm going to make you my favorite vehicle. So, you will let me ride on your back, won't you?
As you command. Just one earnest request. Please don't pull my ears. They're long enough in the first place. All right, hop on.
Let's go, my Rooster Raj.
Ow, my lord! Not my ears! Not my ears!
Don't even think of becoming a demon again. Never again.
No, my lord. I'm very happy to be your servant in this form itself. Come to think of it, I was rather ugly before. But now, I'm kind of cute, don't you think?
Ah, that's just what I've been thinking. Such a tiny little mouse, how could he carry Ganeshi on his back? He was a monster and that is why he could do it.
Yes,
exactly.
Right.
And he continued to be at the feet of Ganeshi. Anyways, I think that story was really cool and fun to listen to. Because just like Mushak Raj, we too are bold and daring.
So how about some more cool adventure stories?
Not now, dude. Now it's time for us to get back home. Friends, I'll see you real soon with some more fun stories about Ganeshji. Cool?
Yeah, sure.
Ganpati Bappa!
Booyah!
प्यारा है यही दोस्त हमारा है
गन्नु सबका प्यारा है यही दोस्त हमारा है जो भी शुभ कार्य होता हमने इसे पुकारा है रिद्धि सिद्धि संग में आए जिसने भी ये बोलिया
Everybody with me.
Praise the Lord. Come on, everybody with me.
Praise the Lord. You come on, everybody with me.
Praise the Lord.
Come on, everybody with me.
सब देवों में सबसे न्यारा दुनिया में मशहूर है. कोई दर्द मुसीबत आए हमसे ना ये दूर है. सब देवों में सबसे न्यारा दुनिया में मशहूर है. कोई मुसीबत आए हमसे ना ये दूर है
हमें दे दे थोड़ा प्यार हमको तेरा इंतजार
हमें दे दे थोड़ा प्यार हमको तेरा इंतजार
डरने की कोई बात नहीं जब सर को झुका के बोले
Sarigoda sareni sa 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 Sarigoda sareni sa 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 Sarigoda sareni
जयकारा जयकारा बोलो मन खुशियों से टोलिया
लोटांगण वंदीन चरण डोळ्यान पाहिन रूप तुझे प्रेमे आलिंगिन आनंदे पूजिन भावे वाळिन म्हणे नामा त्वमेव माझाच पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बंधुश्च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देवदेव कायेन वाचा मनसेन्द्रियेन वा बुद्ध्यात्मना वा प्रकृतिस्वभावा करोमि यज्ञं सकलं परस्मै नारायणाय इति समर्पयामि अच्युतं केशवं रामनारायणं विष्णुदामोदरं वासुदेवं हरिं श्रीधरं माधवं गोपिकावल्लवं जानकीनायकं रामचन्द्रं भजे हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण कृष्ण कृष्ण